Well, hello, everyone, and welcome to Big Mike Senior Adventures.
Well, this morning we're waking up early. MJ and I were heading out to Cabanatuan, Philippines, which is about a couple hours south of here. So we got up this morning. We're walking from the condo up to the jeepney and bus stop, which is maybe about a five-minute walk from the condo. So we're walking up there, going to kick back for a few minutes and wait for the what we thought was going to be the bus, but we see that the schedule is several hours away, so we decided to take the jeepney down. I'm not a big fan of jeepneys, but it's early morning, it's cool, shouldn't be a bad ride, actually. So we figured we'd kick back. We had about a 15-minute wait, so we'd kick back and just watch, see how Science City Muñoz residents get up and get to work or wherever they're going each morning. So it was a nice, enjoyable morning. And I love people watching, so it was a good time. So a few minutes later, the jeepney arrived. We jumped on. Fortunately, there wasn't anybody on there, which is pretty unusual. Usually it's, you know, butt to butt packed, but there wasn't anybody on there. So we were heading out and heading down south. If you've never ridden a jeepney in the Philippines, a little bit different than Thailand. These are a little bit more cramped. They ride around with the back door wide open, which is kind of weird. I understand why, but a little bit different. So in a little bit of time, we did pick up a nice young ladies and started to, you know, fill the jeepney up and made it interesting and enjoyable. Like I said, it's about a two-hour ride. And there's MJ just kind of sitting, relaxing like she always does, very patient. And of course, as you can see, we got starting to get loaded up in the jeepney. And believe me, this is not even close to fully loaded the way it usually is. Usually it's packed. And like I said, it's cool this morning, so not a big issue. So we're on our way. We're heading down. We've got some paperwork we have to do. Then there is a buffet that we've heard about that we wanted to, you know, find and take advantage of. So finally we did make it into Cabanatuan. Once you get in here, you'll immediately notice that the economic conditions have changed. There seem to be fairly well developed. There get a lot of development going on there. And you know, Science City Muñoz is a farming community, very small actually compared to this. But they're both very lovely Philippine towns with great people. I mean, I can't tell you how nice the people are here. Now, they do call Thailand the land of smiles, but I gotta say, my opinion is more so the Philippines is the land of smiles. And I've been to both, so. So we're just kind of riding through town. We're heading down to a government facility, a government office, take care of some paperwork. And then we're going to also head over, and we made arrangements with the hotel, so we're going to spend the night here, and then you know, off into an adventure, hit the mall, and also hit the buffet, and then head back to Science City. It was amazing to me. All the people here, very friendly. Every time that I did hold up the camera to do, you know, my videos, they'd always smile and wave and laugh. And even the old people were very accommodating for things like that, which surprised me. You know, I've had times in the U.S. where they literally flip you to bird if you held your camera up to them. And for me, when we travel, you got a couple ways to travel. This is the tricycle. Usually when I'm on the trike, I'm inside here. I'm 6'2", 230. So I'm more or less in the fetal position riding around. And I know a lot of locals, when they see me get out of there, they always get a chuckle out of it, seeing how big I am. Because these are really designed to accommodate somebody, you know, maybe 5 foot, 100 pounds, something like that. I'm like a chicken getting out of the egg. But this is the facility we went to. Didn't spend long there. Went in, got our paperwork, got out. Then we headed over to the mall to, you know, search out the buffet that we wanted to go to and heard about. So quick ride over on the trike. And then we were at the mall and got there a little bit early. We're anticipate getting hung up in a few places, which we didn't. So that made it nice. We were able to smooth riding all the way. But we did get to the mall a little bit early, so we kind of hung out a little bit, or loitered, I guess you'd say, before going in there. But we did want to make sure and check on our hotel. We checked on a hotel. We booked it. Very close to both the office we had to go to and the mall. It was like right in between, a couple minutes ride. And the lady there was way cool. Really cool room. Had a little kitchenette to it. So we had a kitchenette. We had the room. Good AC. I mean, I cannot say enough about this place. If you are in Cabanatuan, consider going by and checking it out. Very nice location and not very expensive as well. I've stayed at big chain hotels that weren't as nice and accommodating as this. And right outside the door of the hotel, there's a little sorry convenience store. So if you need anything, it's right there. We were waiting. We made our way over to the mall. We're sitting outside. And then, of course, MJ decided she'd work on a little bit of paperwork she had to take care of while we were waiting. And this is right outside the front of the mall. And finally, after, I think it was at 10 a.m., the mall opened, a little bit of a line there. So we were able to get in there. And one thing in the Philippines, you know, in the U.S., guards and whatnot carry 9mm. Here they carry shotguns. So this is not the place you want to play around and try to do anything stupid. So we got into the mall, still had more time. We had probably about an hour, hour and a half before the restaurant actually opened. So we figured we'd kill some time, walk around, check it out. It's air conditioned, it's clean, not very populated yet. Still fairly early morning. So we figured we'd kill it some time, just walk around, check out the mall. It's been quite a while since I've been in a mall. A few months since I was in a mall. Last time was in Pattaya, Thailand. And of course, you know, the Filipinas are not going to do anything unless they get a couple selfies in there. Finally, the restaurant opened, and that's the name of the restaurant, Yakamix. Went in there. It was a great experience. Great, great people. I mean, the folks there, like I said, every time you held up a camera, they were accommodating, you know, give you the thumbs up or a wave, a smile, everything. Food there was incredible. The variety was incredible. And the good thing about it I like, too, is they didn't put out big, massive amounts like they do in the States where stuff will get cold or whatever. They just kept a constant stream of bringing stuff out constantly. The variety surprised me. I haven't seen a variety like this in a few years since I left the States. But I got to tell you that I felt that the food here was better than anything I've had in a buffet in the States. This gal here was very fun. I was dancing around. They had some music going. I'd be dancing around. She was laughing at me quite a bit. We had a great time. There was some ice cream there. They also had, you know, what's a good buffet in the Philippines without the condiments necessary to make, a good dessert? Halo-halo, I should say. If you're in Cabanatuan, or in the area, or going to be heading through there or something, you want a good buffet, I would strongly advise swinging in and catching the buffet. Keep in mind they open 11:30 in the morning. They do shut down. I'm not sure what time they actually shut down. I'm guessing around 2-ish, and they open again at 5:30. So they are shut down a couple hours midday. So make sure you don't head in there that time. And they got the really neat. Now, I know a lot of restaurants we've always gone to, all of us, where they have, you know, you're eating and they'll come around to you when it's a birthday and sing to you. Well, these guys got kind of a unique twist on it, kind of an interesting twist. And I had a lot of fun with them doing that. You'll see here in a minute what they do for their birthdays. But I know that I found it very exciting, fun. This is not just a buffet. This is really an entertainment venue as well. I was surprised with that. I had a great time there. I really did. The staff was great. They were fun. A lot of laughs, even from some of the other customers. Now, needless to say, it didn't take long for us to get our plates full. Of course, I always get a plate full. MJ, she's a little bit more reserved than myself. So she had a pretty good sized plate there, ready to chow down. And of course, you see MJ had just a meager amount there that most Filipinas are gonna have too much. But she was busy, you know, providing cooking food for me on the table as well. And here's the birthday celebration. Now it starts off pretty slow, standard birthday celebration, then all of a sudden it kicks in. Yeah, lots of fun. But fun was over. It was time to get back to Science City Muñoz. So we jumped in our vehicles and headed back. That's all I got for you today, folks. I hope you enjoyed the video. Keep your eyes open for my next video. I'm working on another one. Should be out in the next day or two. And just remember, rolling stones never gather moss. Have a great day.